If you are an options trader, if you are an equity trader, if you are a trader in general, today is the video for you. Check it out because we are gonna talk about a very important tool regarding options. Hi everyone, my name is Francesco Fantechi, and today I want to be talking about a special tool that I use when I basically build my option strategies. And this tool, I already say it was downloaded directly from the internet, but it's my opinion that I want to basically give this content to my whole community that is interested in options, in equities, and in general in trading, because I think it's a very useful instrument, especially if you trade option and complex strategies, because it enables you to build very easily options payoff structure. And by doing so, you can realize what is basically your risk and reward whenever you put in an options trade. Or, for example, an options portfolio with a lot of different options and option strategy. So let's go ahead and let's share the screen here. In particular, I want to open this file. So basically, this file was created by the CFI Institute, which is an institute dealing mostly with finance. Investing is very popular among the financial community. And I want to share with you this Excel sheet that they built because I think it's very useful in understanding a lot of different things. So first of all, here we have a lot of different strategies that you can use. We have both synthetic positions and non-directional strategies, and we also have directional strategies. So basically, we can directly choose among this list of these different option strategies that we want to basically use in order to build our portfolios. And then once we have done so, we can directly use the options list that we have here below. And basically, we have to input different parameters for these options, and then the system and the Excel file calculates independently all the different payoffs and the graph. Okay, so basically, we can also decide to basically put in a portfolio of options without the need to, for example, take precise and predefined strategies. We can simply go into this graph and into this table and put different options and positions that we want to have. We want to make an example now in order to show you how this works. Let's make sure that any premium chart on the basis of strike price type of security and long and short position is not a mathematical approximation made thanks to the Black and Scholes model. Neither is actual data taken from the internet, but I will run random numbers in order just to make you understand how this works. And of course, generally speaking, this would be the approximate premium for these options, with, of course, the fact that this table does not take into consideration the expiration date. So all these strategies will be assumed to be on one single expiration date. So we can't basically build a model in this case that is with more than one expiration date, given the fact that the graph is two-dimensional. Otherwise, we would need a three, four, five, etc. dimensional graph. So in this case, we have a two-dimensional graph, and we are going to make sure that we just use this two-dimensional graph to go through all the options and options premium that we have. So, for example, let's imagine that we have a first security, and the first security we want to be long a call. Okay, so we are long a call with a strike price of $100 and a premium charged of $5 per option. As we can see, the quantity of contracts is just one, which means, of course, as we know, that we move 100 shares. So basically, this contract gives us the right to buy at expiration date 100 shares at a strike price of $100 for with the right to purchase them that is only $5 per 100 share. So what, $5 per share, which is $500 per share. And as we can see, this is the typical graph of a call option. Okay, so we have $5 up until a certain point, and then we can have unlimited profit up until the price of the stock goes up. Okay, then we can imagine to have a second security, which is a put, and also in this case, we imagine to be long a put that has a strike price of, for example, $90. Okay. And in this case, we can see that we have basically built a straddle. Okay, so we are long a straddle, we are long a call with a higher strike price than the put, and therefore our strategy is based on the idea that the security will move a lot in price, whether on the upside or on the downside, and we want to basically profit from our belief that there will be an increase in volatility, and therefore we put in a straddle. We can notice here in this case that, of course, as any straddle, we would lose money if basically if the stock, if the price of the stock remains within this interval, okay, which is around 90. 5 and 100, or it can be between 90 and 100, because we are paying, different options for a total premium of $10. So we would need to calculate the different break-even points. But generally speaking, we know that we have a strike price of 100 and another strike price of $90. Okay, we can also decide to add other options to this graph. For example, let's imagine that we want to be short a call for a strike price of 120, and therefore, since we imagine that the stock is approximately between 90 and 100, we know that the premium for this options contract will be, of course, lower than 5, and we imagine that is $1.5. Okay? So in this case, we have basically, we are short a call option with a strike price of 120. So we imagine that the upside volatility of this stock will increase, but not as much on the upside as above $120. So we want to sell a call at that point in order to, be able to have this view. Finally, let's not build a classical for option strategy such as an iron condor or a butterfly, but let's just go directly into using other two different options that have, for example, just to make sure that we build a strategy that is a little bit more complicated than just one that we find in the books. And for example, we can imagine to be short another call with a strike price of $130 that is worth it $1. So here we are imagining probably or either the volatility is very low or the time of expiration is very low, because as we can see, the premium charged for this option goes down very quickly as we move far from the spot price of the stock. Okay, and finally, we can imagine to be long another put in this case. So here we have a call, here we have a put, and here we are long a put at, for example, $80 with a strike price of $80. And in this case, of course, the premium can be 2.5. Okay? So as we can see, we have a very particular payoff structure. In this case, basically, we have a particular payoff structure that gives us the possibility to make money when we are below a certain break-even point here that will be probably near $90 of strike price, and then we would be losing money in this little figure here that will go from approximately $90 to $100, but of course the break-even points need to be calculated and are not precise. Therefore, don't take me into consideration like precisely for all the numbers that I'm saying. As I said at the beginning, it's just an example to make you understand how this tool works, but we are not using any kind of real world data. And as we can see on the right, we would make money if we are approximately between $100 and $120, but we would be losing money, and here we would be losing endless money if we are above, for example, $130 per share. So that means that something that we could think about doing in this case is adding a long call option in order to make sure that we don't have endless loss in case the share price goes below 130. So for example, we could be long another call at, for example, here 140 for a premium of 0.775, which would limit our loss in case the stock goes beyond $130 per share, approximately, okay? In this case, you can see how easy it is to build on the basis of real world data, very sophisticated and complex option strategies by simply inputting this data on this graph. And you also have down here, so below the graph and below the table with all the different options and options data, you have the payoff structure, okay, of all the different options. Okay, so for any options that you have in this strategy, you will have a certain payoff, as you can see from this rectangle here, and then you will have the payoff structure for every single combined position. As you can see from here, the total loss for the overall option strategy in case the value of the stock goes above, as we can see from here, above 0.75, here would be above $140 per share, we would have just a loss of $750 with the overall combined position, okay? So for example, if our maximum loss is just, these 75, I'm sorry, dollars per the overall position, then it would be very easy to calculate the number of options that we have. Or for example, if our maximum risk is $200 per shares, then we can simply divide 200 by 75, and we know that approximately we would be entering two to three different options contract, okay, for any single position that we have on the strategy. Okay, so I guess that was all for today. I really hope that you appreciated this tool that I proposed you. I'm going to link it down here in the description. If you like the video, please smash the thumbs up and comment down here. So also subscribe to the channel down here if you are eager to learn more about options, finance, investing, money online, and all these different things that we deal on the channel. Thank you all again for the attention. Have a great rest of your week. Looking forward to coming tomorrow with a new video.